Hi everyone, and now it's time to talk about basal body temperature. Do you know what is it? Until now, many doctors recommend that women measure their basal body temperature. Why do it? If you're interested in this topic, watch this video. I'm Dr. Lena Berezovska and I'm glad to see you on my video channel. Measurement of basal body temperature has been recommended for women planning a pregnancy, not only if you are doing it. However, there are many myths about this subject. In addition, the dogma that body temperature should be exactly 36.6 degrees of Celsius, 98 Fahrenheit, existed in many European countries. This dogma no longer exists because we are all different. Body temperature can be different, and it is also different at different times of the day. Normal body temperature is from 33.2 to 38.1 degrees Celsius when measured in the oral cavity. Body temperature can be measured in the auricle, armpit, anus, and vagina, and it will be different. The temperature inside the body is 1.5 degrees higher than the temperature on the surface of the body. Underarm body temperature is normally 35.5 to 37 degrees Celsius. Also, there are people whose body temperature may be slightly higher than normal. This is their physiological norm. During pregnancy, body temperature rises, which is associated with an increase in metabolism. What is basal body temperature? This is the body temperature at rest. It should be measured at the same time of the day and in the same place of the body. Usually the measurement of the body temperature was recommended in morning after waking up. Therefore, the thermometer was usually nearby. As soon as a person begins to move, blood circulation increases, so the body temperature also rises. Measurement of basal body temperature in women has been recommended to determine ovulation. What was this recommendation based on? The menstrual cycle has two phases. The first one is before the maturation of the egg or ovulation, and the second one is after ovulation. These two phases are hormonally different. It was believed that the change in the hormone level leads to a change in the body temperature. Progesterone was considered a hormone that raises body temperature. However, the level of progesterone reaches its maximum level not earlier than 7 days after ovulation. So it's not about progesterone. Old generation thermometers could measure an increase in body temperature by 1-2 degrees. Such an increase was considered normal and was used to explain the change in basal body temperature after ovulation. But it turned out that the temperature increase can be by 0.4-0.8 degrees. That is also the norm. Many women may not see a temperature spike. Several studies have shown that in almost a third of women, the basal temperature does not change after ovulation. And in another third of women, the temperature rises but drops again in a few days after ovulation. Thus, basal body temperature is not a reliable sign of ovulation. But why do doctors still recommend temperature measurement? Quite often, women go to the doctor without serious reasons for infertility. The doctor, having assessed the situation, recommends measuring basal body temperature in women with regular cycles for 3 months as a distraction most often. Sometimes a couple spend too little time conceiving a child. Many women are impatient, and after several months of unsuccessful attempts to get pregnant, they begin to listen to themselves. Measurement of basal body temperature can not only be distracting and soothing, but on the contrary, can cause stress. Without detecting a rise in temperature, a woman may think that she is not ovulating. Indeed, ovulation may not be in every cycle, which is the norm, but the extra stress makes things worse. Ovulation can be, but it is not determined by the temperature factor. Basal body temperature does not show progress or regression of pregnancy. An increase in body temperature may not be noticeable. Also, many factors affect the temperature level. For example, if the temperature is measured in anus or vagina, sex, bowel movements, constipation and diarrhea, bladder filling can change it. If one of you is measuring your basal temperature, don't worry about readings that don't match what described in the instructions. Also, don't worry if your body temperature drops after you miss your period. This is not a sign of a missed pregnancy. If you do not want to have unnecessary hassle, do not measure basal body temperature either when planning a pregnancy or during pregnancy. In a few words, I want to talk about another old method of determining the presence of pregnancy. Why old? Because as I have explained in other videos, we use ultrasound and ECG to confirm pregnancy. We are talking about manual gynecological examination. How can a doctor determine the presence of pregnancy with his own hands? Previously, when there was no ultrasound, women came to the doctor usually with a delay of several weeks of menstruation or with nausea and vomiting, that is 8-12 weeks of pregnancy. By this time, the body of the uterus increased, which could already be detected during examination. The size of the uterus was compared conditionally with the size of a pear or fist, etc. The body of the uterus located within the small pelvis and does not go beyond the pubic fusion until 12 weeks of pregnancy. Filling the uterus with fingers and hands up to 12 weeks was not easy, especially in the presence of overweight or obesity. There are also other signs of pregnancy that the doctor could determine manually or during examination. The cervix becomes softer from 4 to 6 weeks of pregnancy under the influence of progesterone. At 6 weeks, the color of the cervix may change. It becomes a little cyanotic. At 6-8 weeks, softening of the isthmus of the uterus, this is the part between the cervix and the body of the uterus, can be determined. Therefore, the cervix becomes more mobile. 30% of adult women have a uterine inversion, tilted uterus, when the body of the uterus is turned towards the spine, which is the norm. In other women, the body of the uterus is turned towards the pubis. So by 12 weeks, the position of the body of the uterus is aligned and the tilt of the body of the uterus disappears. The doctor is not a psychic, therefore he is not able to see the content of the uterus, the fetus and the ovaries. That is why many doctors and midwives have refused manual examination when making a pregnancy diagnosis. Ultrasound is the best and most accurate method for diagnosing pregnancy. If there are doubts, for example, with an ectopic pregnancy, other diagnostic methods are used. We will continue our journey into the world of the pregnancy in other videos. If you like the video, don't forget to click like and subscribe to my channel. Write what topics interest you in the comments and see you soon.